Hello friends, my name is Madhav Rudraganesh. Today I am going to tell you 7th class science, nutrition in plants. In plants, there are two types, this autotrophic and heterotrophic. So, if you see this video, please keep comment that we should know we are doing nice or not. And if you give us support, we will do better than these videos. And please share this video to your friends. This video is so helpful to your friends. And please like these videos. So let's go into the topic, nutrition in plants, heterotrophic and autotrophic. This autotrophic is, they will do their own food, they don't depend on anyone. Like if there is a tree, it will not depend on others. It will take the sunlight and it will take the water and it will do the food in itself. And how it will be do food means, in the leaves there will be the chlorophyll. In the chlorophyll there will be chloroplasts, like atoms. If two atoms will become means one molecule or two molecules, like that, one substance like that, hundreds of chloroplasts will come together. It is a chlorophyll. So with that chlorophyll they will do the food. The food will come from the roots, because when we will pour water, from that water they will take the food. I think you have understood what is the autotrophic. It will don't depend on other plants. Now I'll tell you the heterotrophic. This heterotrophic is will depend more on the other plants. There are four types in these heterotrophic plants. Parasitic, saprophytic, symbiotic, insectivorous. These are the four types that in the heterotrophic, these four plants will depend on the other plants for the food. Okay, now I will tell you about the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is that it will grow with the combination of the sunrays and the with the water. When the plant is growing, the soil fertility should be nice. When the soil is not nice, in that place we will keep the plant, it will not grow. In the nice soil fertility only you should keep the plant, in that time it will grow. And the sun and the water is also so important in this photosynthesis. When you are pouring the water on the plant, with that water only this plant will do the food, with the help of inside these chlorophylls there will be chloroplast. In this like I told you in starting of this session, atoms and molecules, it will be together, it will become a substance. Like this only, when the chloroplast together, it will become chlorophyll, and chlorophyll is together, it will become a leaf. In this leaf, the chlorophyll help to do the food. Now why is the sunrise is important to the plant? If you are cropping the rice or wheat, more rains it will come, means without the sun rays the crop will be damaged. So the sun rays and the water should be equal. 1% also it will more means the plant will be dried, or this 1% or 2% it will more means it will damage the plant. So the sun rays and water should be so equal when you are growing the plants. That is so important, and when you are growing the plants, that is so important, and the important role in this photosynthesis. Now I will tell you the heterotrophic. Once again I will tell you students, this photosynthesis, this will be do food with the help of chlorophyll. And where is the chlorophyll? Means on the inside the leaves. Because of the chlorophyll the leaves will be made, and this chlorophyll is helpful to the plant, so helpful, and it will give us food. And the made up of with the water. When we pour water on the soil, it will take that water and it will do the food. And when you are growing these plants, you should do in nice soil fertility, not in dusty soil. You will do means it can't grow. You should do nice soil. The soil fertility should be more in that soil. So you do not forget in this photosynthesis. Okay. And sun rays is also so important. The sun rays and water should be equal. Okay, now I will tell you the heterotroph. Now I will tell you the parasitic plant. And it is called host. See, there is a line I draw near this plant. This is called the host. Means it will be like a thread. When there is a plant, it will go like the snake and it will round the plant. When that host will round the plant and it will catch the plant and it will take the secret juices of that plant. So this host cannot do the food. It will take from another plant. So that's why I told you, do this host in this host will round up the plant and it will take the secret juices. You should don't forget this point. Now I will tell you the saprophytic plants. To this plant, it will take nutrition from fungi of dead decaying matter. When we are pouring more water on any plant, because of the water, the fungi will come together and that fungi will catch. It will be stay on that plant. In that time, it will be dead. The plant will be dead, and this saprophytic plant will take the dead or decaying matter of that plant. It will take the juices of that plant. And its shape will be like plant only, but it will also go like parasitic plant, like host. So this saprophytic is like parasitic only, but it will take the fungi of dead or decaying matter of that plant's juices. I think you have understood this saprophytic. I tell you again. It will take the fungi of dead or decaying matter of the juices of plant. I think you have understood. Now I will tell you the symbiotic plants. The symbiotic plants, these plants will associate with other plants to take the food. Means it will associate with means and it will take the shelter to associate with other plants. Means it will go with the other plants like friends like that will gonna. For the shelter, it will go and it will take the food. So this symbiotic will not kill anyone and not do harm to any plant. It will associate with other plant and it will take shelter from any place and it will take the food. So symbiotic is called the associated plant also they will call. I think again I will tell you, this plant will associate with other plants to take the shelter and food because it don't know how to do the like this saprophytic and parasitic. So this plant is so weak, that's why it will associate with other plants. Now I will tell you the insect warriors.
Yes,
it will take secret juices of plants and insects. The insect warriors plants will be like this. Means this is not teeth of the plant, it is the pipe like that. Thread like that will be there in the mouth of the plant. When an insect go inside of that plant, it will catch that insect and it will take the juices of that insect and it will release that insect. After some time, that insect will be dead because there will be no blood inside that insect and the juices of that. And when the plant also, nearby plants of that, it will take the juices of that plants. Will take the juices of that plants of secret and it will take mostly the insects only because the insects only will be go in the most areas in the forest. There will be there that insects, that's why it will take most insect juices, not plant juices. I think you have understood. Again I will explain. It will take secret juices of plants and insects, and that insect it will take more insects. So please subscribe to the channel and like, share, please comment. If you see this video, please comment. I should know that we are doing nice or not. So please share this video to your friends and please like our videos. If you give us support, we will do better than these videos. Bye.